in accordance with your syllabus, I'll be starting with the definition of parliament. As you know, parliament is the law-making body of the government. It's the policy-making body of the government. It is the legislature. All right, you know, in today's modern world, in most of the countries we have democratic government, and all democratic government will be having three wings of the government: the executive, the legislature, and the judiciary. I'll just write them over the board so that you people can jot them down. All right, likhwa mi hai, likhwa mi. So as I said, the government has three wings: the executive, the legislature, and the judiciary. All right. Now, the parliament is actually the legislature, as I just told you. It is the law-making body, it is the policy-making body, and in India, it is at the same time plays a very pivotal role in the governing of the country as well. All right, because in India, the legislative and the executive body work in close cooperation. I'll be describing about that much in detail when we come to it later on. All right, so this is basically, as per the definition, you keep it in your mind that it is the legislature, it is a law-making body, it is a policy-making body of the country. All right, so that is the basic definition. All right, now we are going to study about, very briefly, about the federal setup of this country. You see, this federation is not a very old word, you know. It has come up particularly ever since America became independent and it had a federal set of government. In India, the Article 1 of the Indian Constitution says that India, that is Bharat, will be a union of states. That means the entire country will have so many states and, of course, union territories as well. And these states, the union and the states, will share the power of the government, but the union will be more powerful and the states in India will be relatively lesser powerful, and the states will remain loyal to the union. It means the states will be under the union. In India, the union is more powerful than the states. It has been purposely kept powerful than the states. All right. Now, you see, there are basically three features of federalism. All right. I'll just write them down on the board itself. That is, jaben na khanti ke acha acha acha. খণ্ড লেখা যায় এটা মিটিয়ে দিতে হলে এটাকে মিটিয়ে লিখে দিচ্ছি See, these are the basic features of federalism in India. There is a written constitution, separation of power, that is between union and state, and third, independent judiciary. Now, the question is, why these features are essential? You see, a written constitution. You all know, like the American constitution, India also has a written constitution. And all the laws and policies are written in India. Every details are written in India. Why has that been done? You see, India is such a big country with almost 29 states and 7 union territories. There are so many differences between amongst the various states in India. So that there is no problem that remains amongst the various states with the union. Therefore, everything has been written. Say, as per example, there should not be any confusion between the powers of the state and powers of the union. There should not be any confusion between the powers of the Prime Minister and the Chief Minister. It should be elaborately written in the constitution. It is actually done so as to resolve the disputes between the union and the states. That is why we need to have a written constitution, and this written constitution writes, you know, very, very elaborately. As you know, India is the bulkiest constitution of the world, and every details have been written very, very elaborately. All right. Therefore, we need to have a written constitution. All right, so that there is no confusion. Next is the separation of power. That is the, you can say, dual set of government. We have a government at the union that is called central government. That is called Government of India, that is called Union Government, and there are so many other nomenclature as well. And we have state governments also. Now, you see, the powers of the union and the states have been very, very clearly written. You know, there are two lists. One is called the Union List. Union List is actually meant for the union, that is for the Government of India or the central government. or the union legislature to make the laws. You see, there are state legislature also that makes laws, local laws or regional laws, all right, for the states. So there is no confusion. All right. And that is why the power have been separated. All right, the lawmaking powers also have been separated, and the executive powers have also have been separated. You see, the powers of the various ministers at the state level, various ministers of the union level have been separated. All right, so that is why we need to have a separation of power. Power should be separated between the union and the states. All right. Next is about the independent judiciary. We need to have an independent judiciary. Our judiciary in India, that is the Supreme Court and the High Courts, are independent. They are free in the dispensation of their justice. They are an impartial body, an independent body. All right. Now, why we have to have an independent judiciary? Just to maintain the federalism in India. The reason is that if there is any dispute between the union and the state, or amongst the various states, these disputes are going to be resolved by the Supreme Court of India. As I told you, it's an absolutely independent body, it's a separate body, all right. So it will be dispense justice, all right, without any prejudice, in accordance with the law of the land, in accordance with the law of the Constitution. All right, that is why.